good morning if you're in the USA. Good afternoon if you're in Europe, which I'm sure we have a high level of viewership for this coming game. I'm Gretchen Little here with Dork Mistress, and you're watching the 2018 International WFTDA Playoffs live from Atlanta, Georgia, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Atlanta Rollergirls. Dork Mistress, why don't you welcome everybody on WFTDA.tv to Twitch TV as well?
Absolutely. All the people watching on twitch.tv/WFTDA, welcome to Roller Derby.
That's right. We're going to try to walk you through the game. If you don't know much about it, you'll love it by the time it's over. Today, we're going to see London, the London Brawling of London, UK, taking on the Berlin Wall Stars, new moniker for Bear City Roller Derby's all-star team. Of course, Bear City from Berlin, Germany. London is the number 5 seed in the tournament. They're ranked number 14th in the WFTDA. Berlin is the 12th seed in this tournament. They're ranked number 32. In the WFTDA. Dork Mistress, Your Excellency, could you please give us the London rosters when you're so disposed?
Yes, so playing today for London Brawling, we have 0 Jack Attack, 111 A Russia, 1205 Bratwurst, 1236 Madge, 16 And Dracula, 18 Jukebox, 2 Die Dutch, 3 Onyeka Egwe, 369 Carly McAdam, 4 Delta Strike, 42 Trisha Smackenauer, 8008 Gaz, 84 Katie Helvetica Black, 888 Charlene Scarlett, and number 9 Beth Lord.
Okay, and for the Berlin, I have to think of it to myself because it's a new name. Yep. The Berlin Wall Stars of Bear City. Number 030 is Jane Von Payne. Number 1 is The Lexicutioner. Number 105, Ferocious. Number 109, Amazon. Number 112 is Polytrauma. Number 114 is Freedy Mercury. Number 166 is Sabby Smackdown, excuse me. Number 180 is Miss Sophie. Number 190 is Peanut Butter Panic. Number 2, Master Blaster. Number 23, Sixie Blitz. Number 247, and Captain Catherine Beater Bones. Number 25, Mia Missile. Number 53, Rookie Horror. And number 666, Hannah Satana. Our officials for this day's, for this opening contest: Bambi Lance, Duke Skellington, All In Your Grill, Will Tweeden, Major Wood, Landon Flat, Silence of the Jams, and Viva La Evocion. Excuse me. How about our other officials?
We've got Scotchy Scott Scott, Wishbone Breaker, Lucius Malfoy, Adam Smasher, The Kraken, Chemical Restraint, Tornado Alley, Chucky D, Primeval, Loki Doki, Snarkimedes, and Chiro Fracture. So this is an important game.
It certainly is. We should say, again, number 5 seed London taking on the number 12 seed, the Bear City Roller Derby Berlin Wall Stars. We're going to have a moment of land statement before we get underway.
And that's been completed. So just before we get started, both these teams playing for a chance to progress in the playoffs. First time to the playoffs for Bear City. They've always been in what was previously Division 2 Championship. So this is a big promotion for them and the result of a lot of hard work. London playoffs experts, playoffs champions.
Absolutely. They've been coming to playoffs since 2011. And we talked about it beforehand. We actually, for London was the face of European mm-hmm. roller derby for the first 2 or 3 years yep. that they would participate in WFTDA playoffs. Okay, and the jam line right now, we have Delta Strike for London taking on Mia Missile for Bear City. Both teams focusing on defense right now. Mia Missile bumped to the outside by London. Here comes Delta Strike up front. She gets the first lead jammer of the contest.
Delta Strike played in Malmo last year in playoffs and in the season, the highest scoring jammer for London.
Okay, Mia Missile is through now. Delta Strike is on a scoring pass, going to call off the jam. Wriggled through that pack for a couple of points. We're waiting 3 points go up for Bear City.
And that's important always to get those first points on the board. You want to get that momentum and start putting your head into the head of the other team.
Okay, and on the jam line right now for London, it's Jack Attack, Miss Sophie for Bear City, and we are underway. Jam number two. London, of course, in the pink, Bear in the white. And is this, it is a first jammer penalty going against Jack Attack. So it's a power jam in favor of Bear City.
And this will be important for Bear City to try and put some points on the board.
They are able to put an offensive seal off on. Unfortunately, Miss Sophie, momentum took her to the inside. So she is lead jammer, but she's going to have to pass this pack initially. Now she's through. And in a position to score points, standing in the penalty box is Jack Attack for London.
Just as Gaz for London also goes to the penalty box, to the quad skate shop penalty box.
Well, penalties, for those of you watching the game at first on Twitch, a very important part of the game. And the gameplay does not stop when a penalty is called. That's why the penalty box is as busy as it is. Jack Attack's through the pack. And that will prompt the call-off by Miga Sophie, who got 3 points of her own. So we have a 3-3 time as Dork Mistress.
Absolutely. Just to pick up on penalties. Penalties are 30 seconds for each penalty that you pick up. And you can pick up more than one, just in case that happens later, for all those that are joining us on Twitch.
That's right. And 7, and you're out.
Yep.
So that's for the entire game. Okay, we're back to the live action. Trisha Smackinawa is the jammer. Again, the jammer with the star on the helmet, the scoring player. Jane Von Payne is jamming for Berlin. Jane finds a little room outside, but that is sealed off by Jukebox, I believe. And now at the front, lead jammer London, Trisha Smackinawa.
And Bear City picking up a blocker penalty, which is giving London that pack advantage. All important when you're on a scoring pass.
Boy, Trisha Smackinawa just threw herself into the Bear City defense and is able to, got one to beat. Getting up front is Hannah Satana to stop her progress. But a green light for London. That will be 4 points for Trisha Smackinawa.
That was some excellent one-on-one blocking from Bear City, holding Trisha Smackinawa back, but ended up with another blocker penalty.
Oh, and Trisha is through again, and Jane Von Payne is just having fits with this London defense. We're going to want to watch that a little more closely. Oh, boy, there was an opening. See, that's the thing. If you're new to roller derby, folks, offense and defense at the same time is a phrase you're going to hear quite often.
It's one of the most interesting things about our sport. And if you are watching this and finding it interesting and want to find out more, go to wftda.com/new. And it's got all the information about the game and how to get involved.
Yeah, you are watching a big jam for London right now. 14 points already. And Jane Von Payne has not even made it through the pack once. Now finally getting through on turn three. Because Trisha Smackinawa is the lead jammer, she has the opportunity to stop play, which she does, and is awarded 3 more points. Get 1 point for each opposing blocker you pass after you complete that first trip through the pack.
Being able to stop the jam at any point is really important strategically, because what you want to do is make sure that you score points and that the other team doesn't, and you can control the game. So that lead jammer position is so important.
Yes, it really is. Okay, Mia Missile jamming for Berlin, and for London, it is Andracula. Mia Missile finding a little bit of room outside. Now looking inside, and this will be a lead jam going to Berlin. Mia Missile throughout the regular season actually had a 59% lead jammer rate for Bear City, so no stranger to the lead position. She tosses outside, and 4-0 is the score. So, Bear City fighting back.
Well, so far we've seen both teams get lead twice. And in their history, there was a game London did play Berlin earlier this summer, but it was unsanctioned, and London had a very big win. But these first four jams are showing that Berlin has really taken that experience and thought about how to combat that.
That's right. That one big jam is really the difference in the game. We're going to start this jam with London in a pack advantage. Berlin with one blocker in the penalty box. Dyduk is the jammer for London, pushing the front of the pack. Now looking outside, edges around Hannah Satana, but Hannah Satana gets right back in front of her. Can't hold her, though. Lead jammer, London.
And we've just seen we'd say tit for tat on the jammers.
Master Blaster is jamming for Bear City. And this is a scoring pass now for Dyduk. And, she's finding the going a little bit tough. That's Amazon holding her off, number 109 for Bear City. Okay, Master Blaster is through the pass. No, this is a star pass. That's the other wrinkle for you Twitch fans. This is now Master Blaster taking the star as a pivot. The pivot is the player with the stripe on their helmet, and the jammer can pass that star helmet cover to them. That's what happened here.
It's a tactical move. If you are not lead jammer and you're stuck behind a wall and your pivot is just ahead of the wall, you hand over that helmet cover, they become the scoring jammer, and then you can hopefully try and pick up some points or force the jam to be called.
That's what you said is extremely important, that the pivot really should be in the position to take the star and immediately get out of the pack. If they're stuck in the pack as well, that's trouble. But okay, both jammers on a scoring pass, as I believe. Okay, Master Blaster is through for points. That's four more for Bear City, taking them to 15-4 at the end of the jam, going up for London. So it's 2-1 in points right now. London 30, Bear City 15.
And if you're watching this and want to start skating, check out Atom Skates. They've got new full skate packages at great prices, something for every budget.
And now we have Jane Von Payne to jam for Bear City. Carly McAdam with the star for London. London throwing a lot of different looks up, having many different jammers in the early going, Dork Mistress.
London have a five jammer rotation at the moment, which shows how deep their jammer bench is.
And it's a pack advantage right now in favor of Bear City. And, Jane Von Payne takes advantage of that. She is lead. Carly McAdam able to make it through as well. We can expect Bear City to chase down London. Now, London trying to speed up the pack to make it more difficult for Jane to pass their players. But Jane got three, called off the jam. 3-0 win for Bear City.
And we do tend to see high-scoring games, but when games are really tight, it's 3 points or 4 points or 5 points per jam. We call it we've stolen nickel and diming it.
And they pay off over time. And as you said at the beginning, Dork Misters, as important as scoring is holding your opponent to not scoring. Okay, we're back now to live action. Mia Missile, the jammer for Bear City. Delta Strike for London. Delta strikes through turn one. The pack is not really moving too much right now. A rollback in place on Mia Missile. Oh, nice move by Delta Strike there. Mm-hmm. Finding some space on the straightaway. That's a 5-point pass. She passed the jammer and all four blockers. Now she's looking for more. You see her touch the hips. That's the sign to call off the jam. And four more. She passed all four blockers there. You can keep on scoring points as long as you can keep lapping the field.
Yeah. And just following up that point about the number of jammers that London have, Delta Strike is the first repeat jammer in this game, and you can see why when you see footwork like that.
Yeah, well, and that was at top speed. One of the things that separates a jammer, talent-wise, is the ability to do all of this stuff without having to slow down. We're back to live action now. Jack Attack jamming for London. Miss Sophie for Berlin. Nobody with a clear advantage right now. Hannah Satana, just can't hold off Jack Attack. Jack Attack getting a counter block, really, on Hannah Satana there.
And a lot of jammers work so hard to be able to just take those hits, brush them off, and dance on the toe stops on the inside line to get through.
And that's what you saw right there. Okay, this is a scoring pass for Jack Attack. Not quite so difficult, but now she is through. That is five more for London. Another star pass on the Berlin side, going to Master Blaster again. So, London in control of the jam, calling off already with five. Two more for Jack Attack, and that's a seven-point jam. London 46, Bear City 18.
And we're just starting to see, as you said, London taking control of this game, because we did start with that sort of tit for tat for lead, but London are very much not only getting lead, but when they get it, they're getting multiple scoring passes, whereas Bear City are able to get just one, and that opens that points lead up quite quickly.
Yes, and London really needs to make a statement here as the five seed. The winner gets host in number four seed Atlanta at 8 o'clock tonight. And so, London's got to keep that in mind. Now up at the front, Trisha Smackinawa is awarded lead jammer for London Brawling. Jane Van Payne stuck in the pack. Trisha, boy, coming into the pack hot. It's clean, but gets a little bit of help from her own skater right there. And there we go. That's offensive work for London.
From Jack Attack, I believe. So jammers also play as blockers in this game, so it's just what kind of lineup works best, what kind of tactics you want. So you'll see people in a number of different roles in the game.
Sure, and to have somebody with jamming experience able to play that pivot position is a big help as well. Speaking of which, we have another star pass for Bear City. That goes to Peanut Butter Panic. That will force the call off for London, and it's another 5 points now. London 51, Bear City 18, 16 minutes and 45 seconds to go in the first period.
Just a chance to talk about Quad Skate Shop. Community orientated like no other. Quad Shop is passionate about getting what you want faster, cheaper, and friendlier. Check us out in store or online at quadrollerskateshop.com.
And that Quad Skate Shop penalty box is empty right now. Both teams at full strength, and Dracula getting through for lead jammer for London. Mia Missile fighting and getting stopped. Is that Gaz again with the takeout on the straightaway for London?
Gaz is a power blocker for London, very experienced, been playing for as long as I can remember for London Roller Girls.
Mia Missile is through now, and Dracula is going to call off the jam. We've got to wait and see. Three go up for London, 0 for Bear City. So London 54 now, Bear City 18. London looking to stretch this out, Dork Mistress.
They've picked up lead in the last four jams in a row.
That was a large takedown there. You can see the Berlin blocker heading to the penalty box after that one. It's kind of difficult to go into all of the subtleties of the rules, but you can't block with your forearms or your elbows, and you can't block with anything below the knee. And you can't hit people there either, below the knee. That would, you can't trip people. You can't elbow people. Okay, back to the action now. Diduk again, lead jammer for London. Oh, no. I spoke too soon. She's called for cutting the track. It's a power jam in favor of Bear City.
And one of the things with roller derby is momentum is everything. And so Bear City have a chance with this power jam to get leads, score some points, and, you know, get that momentum back.
Yeah, Ms. Sophie taking on all four London blockers right now, and that is a tough order. You see Anika Igwe right now, she is in the bridging position, but able to participate in rolling back Ms. Sophie. Ms. Sophie through now, though. That's four Bear City. The power jam is over, and Dido Cat not having an easy time in the pack right now.
No, and it's
for London.
But it's good news for Bear City. They were able to score in that power jam, but they don't have lead jammer. That's not available to them. So this will go for a full two-minute jam. Neither team can call it off.
That's right. This is the first full two-minute jam we've had in this game, Dork Mistress. We have 22 seconds left. And right now we have what looks to... Sophie stay in bounds? No, she did not. She's going to have to go back. If you go out of bounds and re-enter in front of the person who knocked you out, that's what the cutting the track penalty means. Diduk now through on a scoring pass. The jam expires. The time expires.
Diduk able to get round at the end of that jam with just a couple of Berlin blockers on the track.
And it's 8-5 on the jam in favor of Bear City. Now that, look at this. You see Diduk getting out. She was initially awarded lead jammer, but then the outside pack referee saw the skate go out of bounds and communicated to the jam referee, and that's when you saw the cut track symbol go about.
But important jam for Berlin. First jam that they scored in seven jams.
That's a big step, yes. Mm. Okay, Carly McAdam out in lead quickly for London, and Jane Von Payne again having difficulties for Bear City. Carly is through for a quick five. And that's one of the things when the pack work gets so constricted here that a fast jammer can re-engage the pack very quickly.
The average lap time in roller derby is about 9 seconds to do a lap. So a jammer, if you can do that in eight, that doesn't give you a lot of time as a blocker to reposition.
Another star pass on the Berlin side going to Peanut Butter Panic. And that will force the call off. Another 5-point pass for Carly McAdam. London now at 69, Bear City at 26.
And we can just see that London haven't just, you know, got used to just started taking control. They are now fully in control of this game.
And looking over at that quad skate shop penalty box, I see one Berlin blocker in the penalty box, and that makes things a little bit easier for Delta Strike. She's through for London, but Mia Missile not far behind for Bear City, and calling off the jam quickly is Delta Strike. She had to because Mia Missile was right on her tail. A 2-point jam for London, 0-4 Bear City. Here we go at the beginning now. And that was blockers as much as it was Delta Strike's quickness that made that happen, Dork Mistress.
Well, the common saying is blockers get the points, jammers go and collect them.
Yeah, and that was right off the starting whistle, and that made the entry space for Delta Strike. We're back to live action. Jack Attack taking up where London left off. Another lead jam now for London. The ladies in pink really starting to take control of this contest. That is a 5-point pass. Miss Sophie still having difficulty in the pack. London really clamping down defensively. Jack Attack, a second scoring pass right now, held up by, number 109, Amazon. And a name that we've said a lot, again, getting into the action now, Hannah Satana, number 666. But, you know, at this point, Jack Attack kind of playing with house money as Bear City can't complete that initial pass.
No, and Bear City unable to go back and provide offense because they're trying to hold back Jack attack. So you get that whole offense, defense, which do you do? Which is most important?
Unfortunately, finally through now, Jack attack with another 5-point pass. That takes London to 81. Bear City still on 26.
And Bear having passed the star four times so far in this game, because they just get stuck behind that tough wall of pink.
And finally, Miss Sophie able to get through now. But, it took her almost a minute and 40 seconds to do that. Jack attack at the front of the pack. Is she going to run this long? No, she will call off the jam. She did give up 1 point. Miss Sophie was hustling till the very end, but 14 for London.
And this is just opening that gap out now to nearly 60 points.
And we have a timeout being called now on the track. It's being called by Bear City. Unexpected at this point in the game, Dork Mistress.
So teams can call up to 3 timeouts each of a minute during the game. And they can just have a bit of a chat about strategy. So I think Bear City are doing that at the moment. How are we going to combat that defense from London? But also, a chance for us to update you on some of the sponsors that have made this happen. S1 Helmets. The S1 Lifer Visor Helmet provides next-level protection.
All right. Well, talk about next level. London doing a really good job. Only 6 team penalties so far in the first period. Almost doubling that is Bear City. Bear City really not in too much trouble, except for Hannah Satana there, who has 3 of her own. And again, 7 and you're out. So with 8 minutes and 58 seconds to go in this first period, you'd rather not have 3.
Yeah.
It's not, it's not something that is an immediate problem, but it's something to keep in mind.
Because the more penalties you get, the less you can be on track to pick up some more.
That's right. Okay, back to the live action. This is Master Blaster jamming for Berlin. Trisha Smackinawa for London. Nobody in the quad skate penalty box right now.
And this is the first time we've seen Master Blaster with the star on her helmet.
Yeah, from the start. She may have taken a star pass, but 2 star passes. Now Berlin starting her as a jammer. One of the longtime Bear City skaters as well.
One of the most famous skaters in Europe, one of the longest playing and a key member of Team Germany.
And there she goes, lead jammer going to Bear City. London was starting to clamp down, but again, caught between the offense and the defense. Another penalty going against Bear City. Now Master Blaster is in a position to call. She does. We're waiting to see 2 going up for London and 0 for Bear City. Boy, that stings when you get lead and you don't score.
And it's their first lead in 9 jams. But it's, again, all about the defense. London were able to keep Master Blaster back behind their hips.
Yeah. Check out that big hit by Jukebox on the outside. That forced Master Blaster there. You see the replay, very interesting to watch the action in slow motion. Back to action now. Mia Missile with the jam star for Berlin, and Dracula at the front of the pack, lead jammer London.
It's becoming a common story, but it is because the defense by London is so strong that they're able to just get their jammers through and clear the lanes for them.
That's right. Here comes a scoring pass now for Andracula. Not going to take chances, calling off the jam. 4 points. London can afford to do that right now. And that's another thing that we want to, make the viewers aware of, whether you're watching on WFTDA.TV or on Twitch, is that, irrespective of the results of this game in terms of win or loss, there's also rankings implications.
Yeah. And rankings are, they last for all of the tournaments and make sure that you get selected, so that they're really important for teams.
That's right. We'll try to explain a little bit more of that. Diduck pushing the front of the pack for London, and she is awarded lead jammer. Miss Sophie still being held off right now. Annika Ingwe, basically holding her off by herself. Now through for the initial pass is Miss Sophie. Scoring pass for Dyduk, and she turns around, calls off the jam.
But it's also great tactical awareness from London that the blockers speed up the pack at the same time to try and give as much time as possible to make that decision about when to call it off.
5 points going up for London. Here we have Dyduk hinting into the pack, and it, oh, nice spin right there. Yeah. Then, you know, no offense to Freddie Mercury. She was in the right position, but Dyduk just took that pivot, and there she was off to the races. Okay, Delta Strike now. Oh. Speak about off to the races. Lead jammer for London. Master Blaster getting stood up by Jukebox for London. Jukebox, of course, you know, those of you who've been involved with WFTDA Derby for a long time, made her bones in Minneapolis and then moved to London a couple of years ago, coming back from maternity leave this year, and hasn't lost a step, obviously.
No. But I think didn't leave roller derby, was very involved in coaching, so has kept up with all of the tactics and the strategies as they do change year on year.
Isn't that the truth? Okay, another 5-0 jam now in favor of London. And yeah, there you see Delta Strike, just another pivot move. That's London's bread and butter right now. She got past the pack and chose to call it off rather than continue forward progress. All right, back to the action. Mia Missile for Bear City. Bear City really needs to make a punch right now. 4 minutes to go, essentially. You know that they didn't fly almost 4,800 miles to do nothing here.
No, and they will want to go into halftime with a bit of momentum, a bit of feeling that they can catch this up.
Yeah, Carly McAdam, though, I believe she is 3-for-3 lead jammers status for London. A happy surprise. Maybe not a surprise to the London fans, but Carly McAdam, not the the name jammer, if you will, for London.
No, and when you look at the season, is probably the fourth jammer in terms of points per game. So this is a great performance from Carly McAdam.
Oh, and we have a high block penalty now being called on Mia Missile. Power jam in favor of London. Yeah, this is, you couldn't draw this one up any better for London. If you're a fan of the brawling now, going into halftime on a power jam. And do we have a call-off? We do. That's a 9-point jam in favor of Carly McAdam, who is getting some love from her teammates. Yeah, big performance for Carly in this first period.
Having a great first half. Opportunity to talk about Bont. Lighter, stronger, faster. The original carbon fiber boot. Check them out at bont.com.
And this will be a power jam start by calling that jam with Mia Missile still in the penalty box. That gives London the opportunity to start this jam unopposed, and it works out in favor of Jack Attack, who gets through and is lead jammer.
London there, very clever in breaking up Berlin so that they couldn't hold back Jack Attack. But then this jam, what was that, Gretchen?
Oh, that was an apex jump that was set up nicely by London. You see the pivot right there, and I'm missing the number right now, but that, oh my goodness, that's another 5-point pass. Mia Missile is out of the penalty box. Oh no, she passes the star to Peanut Butter Panic, who's immediately called for a cut track, so the power jam continues in favor of London.
And this is going to open up that lead for London just before we go into halftime with only three, actually now four, it's the announcer's curse, of the Bear City blockers. Again, London trying to do what we call hold a goat, which is hold one of the blockers at the back of the pack so that you control the pack speed. And that makes it easier for your jammer.
Oh, boy. What a coordinated attack on that jam. Trisha Smackinawa just cleared out the inside of turn three. And here we have that apex jump again, going up airborne. And again, the distraction by London's pivot was what made that happen.
But there's also opportunities. When Bear look like they're about to threaten a star pass, it opens up the LRG's inside line. They're moving to try and trap that pivot and control it, and that's giving an opportunity for the Bear City Jammers.
Oh. And we have an official timeout right now. Let's check. Okay, Anika Igwe did pick up that second penalty. But again, London doing a good job. One period almost in the books, and only one skater with two penalties. Meanwhile, Peanut Butter Panic and Hannah Satanic both with three for Bear City, and another power start for London, this time with Trisha Smackinawa wearing the star, quickly awarded lead jammer.
Yep. And this jam brought to you by Radar Wheels. WFTDA playoffs are brought to you by Radar Wheels. Radar Halo experience world-class edging.
And talk about the London determined defense. That's Peanut Butter Panic at the back of the pack. The power jam is over, but Peanut Butter Panic has not made it through to turn two. Meanwhile, Trisha Smackinawa already with 4 points on a second scoring pass.
And getting some offense there from the pivot for London, just trying to smash open that wall. Strongest defense we've seen from Berlin in a few jams.
That's
and
right.
This is the kind of thing they need to do to hold back the London jammers.
I believe that's number 9, Beth Lord, up front in the pivot position, getting quite physical and finally getting Trisha through. Smackinawa now with 9 points for London. The period clock has expired. We are on jam time right now. For those of you watching on Twitch, new to the game, this jam will continue until either the lead jammer calls it off or the 2 minutes expire.
And we're just watching what's going on in the pack.
Punishing pack work.
So this is great defense from Berlin. We want to see more of this.
yes. Those of you watching from Bear City, I'm sure that you agree. Trisha Smackinawa being rolled back all the way to turn one by Catherine Beater Bones. But on the other side of the coin, though, the offense is just not there. Finally through, though. And, well, London knew exactly where Master Blaster was. 5 more points put up at the end of the jam. So London really making that statement we talked about, Dork Mistress.
This is what they need to do. So they've come into this tournament as seed number 5. Only the top 3 get to go to championships. So they are going to have to come in and show everybody that they are here for one of those 3 spots.
Yes. And for Bear City, now they've got to start thinking, you're not going to give up the game just yet. There's a lot of roller derby to play. 30 minutes more of action coming your way after this halftime break. But you also have to start thinking about limiting London's offense and getting this differential back, because as we said, the rankings are apply to this game every bit as much as they do to every other sanctioned game.
Absolutely. And to show the sort of progress of the two teams, so they played a non-sanctioned game in August and London won by around 130 points. They are nearly 130 points ahead now.
Yes.
So I think they've definitely thought about that game and what they've learned about how to shut down Bear City.
Well, in Atlanta, of course, as the host, was asking all of the teams to send a lip sync video. And London did a very cute one to the Mary Poppins song, Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious. I'd have to say this first half was pretty supercalifragilisticexpialidocious for London Brawling. We'll be back with half number 2 in 13 minutes. You're watching WFTDA.TV. Welcome back to the 2018 International WFTDA Playoffs from Atlanta, Georgia, brought to you by the Women's Flat Track Derby Association and the Atlanta Roller Girls. I'm Gretchen Little with Dork Mistress, and we've seen the first half of London versus Bear City. What are your thoughts?
So it was always going to be tough for Bear City in this game. London are such an experienced team, and they're so many ranks higher in the WFTDA. And that's really shown in this game. The first few minutes, Bear City did really well keeping up with London, but then London just put on the afterburners, shut down Berlin Jammers, and have taken this game in this first half.
Yeah. What about scoring? I mean, London's jammer rotation is really giving Bear City a lot of challenge, I think. You know, because there are five jammers, and each has a different style.
Six jammers. Which is one of the deepest jammer rotations we'll probably see all tournament. And it's, you know, you've got some jammers. So Jack Attack, number zero, scored 45 of London's 148 points in the first half.
That's a big contribution.
Yeah, it's been Jack Attack and Delta Strike who, between them, picked up over 80 points. And, you know, the other jammers are there, and they are still scoring points, you know, 20 points, 19 points. However, those two have been able to really capitalize and get some big scoring jams in.
Yeah, well, you know, it's not, we can't write in the bracket just yet. 30 minutes of roller derby to go.
You never can, and it depends how Bear City have gone away in halftime and thought about how they're going to change this up. Because we know that they can get this game to be tighter. We know that from previous games that they've had this year and previously. So, I'm looking for Bear City to come out on fire after halftime.
They certainly are going to try. Both teams with full complement of skaters. That quad skate shop penalty box is currently empty. It is going to be for London, Delta Strike again, jamming. And for Bear City, that is number 25, Mia Missile. Here we go.
Both heavy rotation jammers, and as we've seen, Delta Strike, one of the highest point scorers, shows why lead jammer for London.
Yeah, and just taking face-to-face the one defender for Berlin and overpowering. Mia Missile is through as well. A little nudge into the pack, 1 point going up for London.
And that's key. Berlin holding that jam to just 1 point, forcing that call off. This is what we want to see.
Yes, Miss Sophie now on the line for Berlin, and Jack Attack for London. That jam going very quickly. No penalties assessed. Still 4-on-4 in the pack. Yeah, the ramifications for a huge London win here for Bear City. Bear City's going to play a consolation game if they do not come out victorious, as will London. The winner, though, gets Atlanta at 8 o'clock again tonight, and that's going to be a test. So here we go right now. One would understand if London, at this point in the game, thought to keep that in mind. But they have to beat their opponent first. Yeah. That's right here on the track.
And as you said, it's not just about beating the opponent. The differential is important for ranking. So, you know, it's very tempting at this point for London to go, you know what, we can perhaps...
We have a power jam Bear City, just as we're talking about don't count your chickens.
Yeah.
So, Jack Attack in the penalty box, 4-4 in the pack.
Announcer's curse is a real thing.
And here it is. Now coming in offensively for Bear City is Master Blaster. And Master Blaster going to take another shot. London doing a good job of holding off this power jam, though.
Master Blaster didn't start jamming in this game until close to halftime. But clearly, having the success is getting through. And so is higher in the rotation.
Okay, Jack Attack out of the penalty box, through the pack. 5 points for Ms. Sophie. Still a half a track advantage now. Oh, and Ms. Sophie hits hard, and the London bench wanted a back block, but it was clean contact. Ms. Sophie will call off the jam. 3 points going up for London now, And for, you know, giving up a power jam and coming out 3-5, that's not a bad result.
No, that's a result the Bear would have wanted to see, a bigger differential. So they would have wanted to pick up more points. But again, strong defense from London, just shutting down that chance to get power jams.
And Dracula for London now. And she'll be taking on, Sabi Smackdown. First jam of the day for Ms. Smackdown. Mm-hmm. And Dracula quickly through for lead jam for London.
So that's the fifth jammer we've seen from Bear City. I mean, with the 31 points they've scored, number 180 has picked up most of the points, 11. But Master Blaster has picked up 8 points, all as pivots.
Boy, the London defense just really clamping down at the front of the pack. Jukebox rocketing to the front of the pack now, getting some assistance from the other teammate as well. And Dracula on the other end of the pack, though, having to go it on her own for London. This is a scoring pass, though, and Sabi Smackdown still not through the pack all the way into turn three now. Peanut Butter Panic and Hannah Satana getting into it defensively along with Amazon. And finally, a penalty going on Bear City. That's a 5-point pass for London. Back to, okay, another star pass now for Bear City. This is Peanut Butter Panic.
And we've seen Peanut Butter Panic pick up the star pass a number of times. Bear City very smart about trying to get that star pass across to force the call off to minimize the damage.
And Peanut Butter Panic bumped to the infield by Jukebox, rolled back to turn one. London choosing to run this jam long, Dork Mistress.
And I think that's just showing the strength of their defense. The bench has confidence that the defense can hold Berlin's jammers back. So they're like, yes, let's run this long.
14-3. Here we go. Coming in around the outside. Boy, that is just confident skate work there by Ann Dracula. And again, at speed, making that move.
And wheels are important. Savant Wheels by Atom. Light, fast, and responsive. Everything you look for in a wheel.
You know, I didn't stop to think about that, but you're 100% correct, Dork Mistress. Okay, this is Die Dutch jamming for London. Thank you, Twitter, for correcting us on that pronunciation. Getting lead, calling it off quickly, and a 0-0 jam. We haven't really mentioned that. Of course, at this point in the playoffs, who doesn't know that you can join in the conversation on Twitter with the hashtag #talk2 WFTDA.
So we're in a quick official timeout. We're just making sure that the infield is safe because I think there's been some water spilled. And that doesn't work with wheels. Water and wheels do not go together.
No, and that's actually a subplot to the tournament. Those of you who are not aware there was a quick track change as of yesterday.
Chance, so it's not just wheels that are important. Knee pads, durable, functional, stable. The S1 Pro knee pads are built for roller derby.
And there we have the penalty breakdown again. And nothing really sticking out. Anya Igwe did pick up the third penalty, but for London, not really a serious problem.
I think both teams are playing really clean, apart from two or three players who are picking up multiple penalties. This is a very clean game so far. I've obviously now jinxed it.
It could go off the rails at any time. No, but on a per game basis for the season, London with a 5.8 jammer penalty per game average and a 24.4 blocker penalty per game average. So that's pretty good.
That's really low.
That's a clean average in general. We're back to live action now. Carly McAdam jamming for London. Miss Sophie again for Bear City. Carly at the front of the pack. Bear City digging in defensively, though. Nothing is coming easy.
We started seeing that defense come together at the end of the first half, and this is what Bear City need to do to make it as difficult as possible for the London Jammers to get out, to tire them out, and to burn down the clock.
Yeah, and now the London Pivot being forced to bridge, now coming in offensively, but no clear advantage to either Jammer. Miss Sophie being rolled back.
I would bet that this is the longest jam we've had without a lead jammer, nearly 50 seconds now.
Yes, and that does not show signs of changing, as both jammers really vexed by the defense right now. And, of course, Carly McAdam able to, you got to give credit to the London Pivot as well. I'm looking, I believe that is Beth Lord again, number 9. For London, really, and that didn't come the first time. She had to try that move several times.
Beth Lord standing out as a blocker in this game. Again, having there are some London players having a really great game today.
Yes, back on scoring pass now. Carly McAdam is, it's like, well, I got out of the pack for a while. Now you mean I have to go back into this mess? Yeah, it's not a pleasant place for jammers right now between turns 1 and 2, but Carly McAdams finds room.
Just that little hop skip on the inside to... And it was just, again, that was cleared for her by the blockers.
Yes, and now a second scoring pass. Miss Sophie still not through on the initial. Finally making it through, taking the helmet cover off for a second. But another 3 points going up for London. London now just sort of, blink and you miss it, going up by 140 points. Here. And there you go, Carly McAdam again. Beth Lord pushing in and then taking the attention of the Bear City away.
Support for this stream is brought to you by Radar Wheels. Radar Halo, number 1 in all wheels for Derby.
Delta Strike finding room inside. Lead jammer for London. Sabby Smackdown getting caught in that tough London defense again with the star. For Bear City, a scoring pass. Boy, Delta Strike, so strong on that outside.
Brushes off significant hits from blockers while staying on her toe stops, which is no mean feat.
No mean feat at all. Now back into the pack for another scoring pass. Sabby Smackdown is through, and Delta Strike knocked to the infield. Going to call off the jam now. One additional point, 6 on the jam, 180 London, 34 Bear City.
Sometimes you just think, you know what, I'm not going to get through this pack. I'll call the jam and we'll have another go at it. And you have that luxury when you're looking at the points differential. But still, 6 points in that jam, even though that felt really quick.
That's right. That's right. Yes, London, I'm sure, would like to carry some of this momentum if they are to prevail versus Atlanta. Now we've got Mia Missile with the star for Berlin and Jack Attack for London. And both jammers kind of switching position. Mia Missile not quite able to stay on the track. Ridden out, rolled back.
That was great work by London, because Mia Missile thought they were back on track in time, but actually had to go back out, and it just ate up seconds.
Yeah, and I'm sure that London has been studying their tape of previous game play, because that's one of Mia Missile's kind of signature moves, is that toe stop dance on the outside straightaway. This time, though, Bear City very tough defensively, rolling back. Jack Attack. Mia Missile at front, lead jammer Berlin.
And this is what happens when you have such a pack advantage with Bear City, with a 4-3 pack advantage on track. And you get lead.
Yeah, it took a minute. And Mia Missile going airborne, not able to land in bounds. Going to be rolled back. That's Beth Lord again.
Mm-hmm. When you think about games, you think, who are you talking about? We're talking about Beth Lord as a pivot. Absolutely captaining the team on track and making sure everyone's in the right place.
That's right. And that's exactly what you want your pivot to be able to do. Jack Attack does make it through now after taking the helmet cover off. At this point, Mia Missile's going to call the jam, but one might take the strategic rankings-oriented position at this point that if you're down, you might want to go long on some of these jams.
Yep. Absolutely, because London will be looking to have that massive differential that they're working towards. Bear City will want to close that up so that it's not as close.
Yeah, there you see, again, the attempted apex jump, timeout. They're all, they're just derby terms. And again, the seal off by Beth Lord.
Mm. London very much in control of this game. But while we're in an official timeout, we'll just talk to you about Quad Skate Shop. Community orientated like no other. Quad Shop is passionate about getting you what you want faster, cheaper, and friendlier. Check us out on store or online at quadrollerskateshop.com. Also interesting, first time London has been scoreless since Jam 6 of Period 1.
Oh, my.
Wow. So that,
oh, my. That is a very interesting statistic brought to us by Shady Hawkins, our esteemed producer here at the broadcast table. We want to give some love to everybody. Speaking of giving love, we've mentioned some statistics already. We have been the beneficiaries of a beautiful sports information book that's been put together for all the teams competing here in Atlanta. And we want to thank Amy Jo Moore and Obstinate and Mr. Whistler and the Sports Information Committee
for making us look smart.
Making us sound smart, at least. I don't think anything could make me look smart. Sports Mistress. But, yeah, as we were saying, we're looking at the penalties there. For Berlin, it's a noticeable difference, and you're kind of seeing it play out. Their blocker penalty per game average for the season was 30.14. Now, their star pass average per game was only 3.8. They went way over that, I think, even in the first period.
Yeah, but I think that's because they're playing a team that is so strong on defense that they have to switch up their tactics. I mean, and I think much as we have all of those season statistics, sometimes things really change. So, I mean, Jack Attack is having an amazing game
for
London Brawling. Played 4 games during the season, was only picking up 12 points per game, and is now, sort of the lead point scorer.
Yeah. Yeah. It's been very interesting to see this jammer rotation for London. Coming into the game, their top scorers were Delta Strike and Dracula and Trisha Smackinawa. And we really haven't seen Ann Dracula and Trisha Smackinawa to the extent that we've seen some of the other jammers.
No, and for Berlin, Master Blaster is a regular rotation jammer. She didn't start the game as a regular rotation jammer and has come in as the game has gone on. So things have really changed up in this, in this international playoff.
Sure, sure.
So you can't look at the season and think you're going to be able to predict playoffs.
No, because each game has its own dynamic. And, you really got to – okay, speaking of Ann Dracula, of course, now she does take the track and is immediately awarded lead. Took her about 6 seconds. Jamming for Berlin is Jane Van Payne. Jane making it through Ann Dracula scoring 4. And now, of course, you see perhaps letting the clock wind down a little bit. No, and Dracula's going to run this one long. Mm-hmm. Interesting that the leading team would try to run long here. But at this point, of course, London's very anxious to let this clock wind down. 4-2 on the jam. So 8-2 in favor of London.
And we've just had confirmation that long official timeout was for track repair, as we suspected, by the close-ups of the action. And a huge thank you to all of the volunteers and the track tape crew, because they have the toughest job.
Oh, absolutely. And as we said, it was a very quick implemented decision, excuse me, to go to the sport cart instead of the polished concrete as originally planned, because there are grates here, and the committee just realized that the safety of all involved on roller skates was the most important aspect. Okay, back to the action. Trisha Smackinawa is awarded lead jammer for London. Miss Sophie is in the pack fighting that London defense. Now Trisha is through. This is a scoring pass. And boy, that Bear City defense is digging in. Hannah Satana there, that almost appeared that Trisha was through, but now she's being rolled back by Master Blaster.
But Ferocious it for Berlin is back on the track from the penalty box, and that just gives Bear City that bit extra advantage to have a full pack on track.
Yeah, Trisha Smackinawa, of course, again, in great position. She's lead jammer and on a scoring pass, and Ms. Sophie has still not completed the initial, so we're a minute and 24 seconds into the jam. Finally calling it off with 4-0 on the jam is London.
I mean, that pack work was really interesting. Normally you can see packs split into two tight walls of three with an offense waiting or bridging, but in the end that just became a big brawl. and so London just went, you know what, no.
Yep. Well, let's see if we can regroup and see what's next. London brawling, though, living up, of course, to their name. Carly McAdam with the star again for London. Sabi Smackdown for Bear City. And, ooh, Carly McAdam is being called for a low block. And this is a power jam in favor of Bear City.
Sabi Smackdown with a great opportunity to push just past the one London blocker, but is hit out and recycled.
Oh, and an illegal contact penalty is going on the London pivot, but Sabi Smackdown forced to recycle in any event.
That was smart tactics by Katie Helvetica Black to that big recycle. And so, you know, even if you're not sure, you have to go all the way back.
Yeah. It was just, you know, at this point, dueling jammer penalties is not going to do you any good. And Carly McAdam quickly picks up another jammer penalty, seemingly threw the pack on the initial pass, but cut the track.
And I think you could hear the whole room and us go, no.
So Bear City now in full offensive mode, but London very staunchly defending. This is a scoring pass for Sabi Smackdown, but with 40 seconds left in the jam clock, how long will it take before she... is not a scoring pass. My goodness, I got ahead of myself. Lead jammer going to Sabi Smackdown for Bear City.
But that took 90 seconds, which means you've only got opportunity for one or two scoring passes, even in a power jam situation.
Well, and boy, the scoring pass took a lot, lot less time than the initial. That is five now. Boy, you got to think you might want to freeze the jammer if you're Bear City, but Sabi Smackdown approaching. Yes, she will call off the jam with Carly McAdam standing in that quad skate shop penalty box.
Very interesting. We've been able to see over the last few jams how Bear City are working together. They're pairing up their jammer and pivots. So if Zoffy is the jamming and she's stuck behind a wall, she's passing it to Master Blaster. And if it's number 30, if it's Jane Van Payne, she's passing it to Peanut Butter Panic. So very interesting that they're actually pairing up.
Yes. Well, all right. Mia Missile now with the star for Bear City, and the penalty is over on Carly McAdam, but Carly McAdam already with two trips to the penalty box. Mia Missile rolled back by Jukebox and now fighting the rearward portion of the pack, and there's the Mia Missile we know and respect, lead jammer For Bear City.
The speed and acceleration, seeing that gap and getting through it in milliseconds, that was hugely impressive.
Yes, and now, of course, a scoring pass. Carly McAdam having to watch it, might have been spooked a little bit by those two box trips, is still on the initial pass. This is a scoring pass for Mia Missile. She is through, and she gets four.
This is the only time in the game Bear have had back-to-back lead jams. So, hugely important.
And, you know, at this point, like we said, there's a lot to be said for running this long. And that's what Bear City are doing. Carly McAdam, though, making it through. Very nice skate work, staying on the inside line. So, it's 4-4 on the jam. Now, Bear will call. I believe Mia Missa got her four, so 8-4 on the jam. Bear City with 52 now. London 196, 11:37 to go.
Opportunity to talk about Bont. The Athena plates, lightweight aluminium 20-degree plates. Come take a look at bont.com.
There goes Mia Missile, and again, coming out through the pack. I remember the first time she came to the U.S. to play, and I thought, she is a missile. And she certainly looked like it there. All right, Jane Von Payne jamming for Berlin Delta, excuse me, Jack Attack for London.
But Bear City pivot picking up a penalty, so there's going to be little opportunity to star pass.
Oh, and another blocker penalty going on Bear City, 4-2. It's one would think just a matter of time for Jack Attack, but there comes some offense for London. Boy, the two remaining blockers, Hannah Satana and looking for the number, really did a good job holding off Jack Attack. She is lead, however.
Gaz was there with the offense for London. Again, power blocker, great offense, will break up walls. And that's been London's plan. Not only are they providing strong defense to hold back the Berlin Jammers, they're not letting Berlin build the walls that they'd like to.
That's right. Master Blaster able to do some work individually and knock out Jack Attack, roll her back. So now she is pushing the rearward portion of the pack. We're kind of at an impasse right now. Jane Von Payne does make it through the pack on the initial.
But as you can see, it's again turned into a bit of a scrum in the pack where there's no defined walls, and it's become a bit one-on-one. And that's not something you're going to want as a jammer. You want clearly defined walls so that you can find the gaps and break them down or get the offense. When it gets like that, it gets really complicated.
Yeah. 5 points did go up for London on that, but she probably passed all of those blockers multiple times and then had to go back and just, you know, the Berlin defense resetting. Took a long time. Okay. Die Dutch back on the track with the star versus Ms. Sophie for Berlin, and we have a full pack right now. Die Dutch lead jammer for London.
That outside line was left clear, and Die Dutch is going to take it.
Oh, yeah. Now, she may be called on a back block. She is. This is another power jam in favor of Berlin. Let's see what they can do.
Berlin will be looking to close that gap down. Their last game, they were about, because I can't do the maths in my head, about 130 points behind. They're not far off that now, so that's, I think, going to be a really big goal for them in this last 8 minutes.
Oh, sure, yeah. Well, they're looking to at least score like 51% differential. That would potentially help them from a rankings perspective, if nothing else. But London's been stingy when they've given up the power jam. They do not make it easy for Bear City's jammer.
Because that's the crucial thing. You get this 30 seconds of essentially free time, and if the other team stop you from scoring, then you might as well not have had the power jam.
Yeah. Die Dutch is out of the penalty box. The power jam is over. Four going up for London. Now, neither jammer will be able to stop the action. Die Dutch on a second scoring pass, forcing attention to themselves, and Master Blaster with a authoritative knockout.
But interestingly, Bear up front there, not walling up, taking on Dijac one-on-one, which is an interesting tactic.
It certainly is. Now we have a cutting the track penalty going on Ms. Sophie with the star in hand. So the star goes to the penalty box and the jam times out. So it'll be a 30-second power jam in favor of London when play resumes.
Yeah. And when, while we're in this 30 seconds chance to talk about Atom Skates, colored Falcon plates are a great option for a great price. Or for me, because I like being fancy.
Fancy is nice.
And so Bear City have called a timeout. So that's that 1 minute chance to re-strategize. And I'd expect that again at about this time. And I think, it's that chance to try. If their goal is to keep that points differential to what it was or better.
Yeah, they really need to regroup a little bit.
They really do. And I think it's all about their defense at the moment for me, that they're not walling up together enough. They're letting London break them up. But even when they're up front, they're not sticking close enough to each other. And they're not blocking all the way to the line. And what we mean by that is that they're trying to do the block. They're trying to push the jammer out to the side. But they're not pushing them. They're not blocking all the way to the line, and the jammers are sneaking around.
Yes, and I think if I understand what you're saying, Dork Mistress, that movement, if it's unsuccessful, tends to break up the defensive formation.
Yes.
Because it pulls the blockers apart. You saw the penalty situation right there. You got to give your hands off or hands to Hannah Satana, who's been playing almost every jam with three penalties and hasn't gotten any more. Peanut Butter Panic, on the other hand, did get two more. So now is with five, jamming on the power jam for London, and Dracula makes it through lead jammer for London Brawling. Now a scoring pass, a coordinated offensive strike. But
as we've talked about, London trying to break up that wall, achieved it, but there was still a hit out to the inside in the recycle.
Power jam is over, and Dracula calling off the jam, 4-0. A little slow to get up, but good to see her on her own getting back to the bench. There she breaks the defensive structure, and again, as you said, Dork Mistress, the Bear City defense was affected by London's offense.
And we've just heard from Twitter feedback that that Bear City's lack of shapes is stressing people out, and this is again, lack of, because we talk about triangles or tripods or walls, and London just able to break up those blockers in white so that they can't form a shape.
Mia Missile is lead jammer for Bear City, but being dealt with effectively by London, and as a result, Delta Strike on a scoring pass as well. And Mia being rolled back, she was bumped out by looking for the number. Excuse me, Annika Ingwe and Jukebox involved defensively as well. I believe that may be, well, in any event, Delta Strike able to stay in bounds. That was an impressive bit of work there.
I think a lot of people have Delta Strike as a bit of a jammer crush because of just her ability to stay on her toe stops or on her skates, brushing off those hits. It's just, you can't move her.
No. And if you do, she's just going to bend a little bit so that the impact doesn't affect her progress. London's over 200 now. They've got 218. Bear City with 56. Where has the time gone?
Well, I've got time to shout out to Rydell Skates, proud sponsor of the 2018 WFTDA playoffs and championships. Thank you very much.
All right. Carly McAdam again jamming for London. A very strong showing lead jammer now. Carly McAdam really jamming for profit for London in this game. Jane Van Payne with the star for Berlin and still working on the initial pass. Here we go, another grind now.
And I think we're seeing a bit of change in this half from tactics from Bear City. We've seen we've seen fewer star passes because they're doing the defense, and we've just seen that that hasn't been successful in keeping back Carly McAdam.
No, and you know, in Bear City doing a much better job of forming the defensive shape there, but Carly McAdam saw her opportunity and had the momentum, was able to squirt through on the inside. Second scoring pass right now. London very content to just let the clock run right now.
But that was a prime example of Berlin not blocking to the line, that they left a gap on the inside, and Carly McAdams gets through it.
Yep, Jane Van Payne completing the initial pass. Carly McAdam bumped out, and London gonna run the gym. No, okay. Yeah, we have Carly McAdam engaging at the back. Jane Van Payne at the front. The London pivot going shoulder to shoulder right now. And boy, as you said, Dork Mistress, London able to complete those line-to-line blocks.
Yeah. And that's absolutely crucial, especially if you're going off on your own as a single blocker, breaking up that wall. You've got to go all the way to the line and push that jammer out, or you're just going to make it easier for the jammer to get through.
And the jam times out, 2 points awarded to both teams at the end of that pass. So it's a 12-2 jam in favor of London, and we have time out being called. 2 minutes and 35 seconds to go. Boy, if you're a London fan, you've got to be satisfied.
Yep. Bess, I think, just came up on our screen before that replay.
Yep, and there we see that was when the wall broke down and Carly McAdam immediately shot that inside line. Very, a very aware work for London all game long. Okay. Well, Carly McAdam, of course, picked up those two quick jams or penalties, Shell and Scarlet with three now. But London doing a good job spreading the penalties.
Yeah, and, you know, for those of us who aren't used to watching roller derby, it is quite a physical game, quite tiring. So you quite often see teams pick up more penalties in that second half. But I think the Peanut Butter Panic is the person most in trouble at this stage. But Bear City are picking up more penalties, and something that they're going to want to really, you know, work on for the future, I think.
That's right. Okay, Trisha Smackenawa with the jam star for London. Mia Missile again for Bear City. And no clear advantage right now. 3-on-3 in the pack.
And it's... you want your fourth blocker on track so that they can provide some offense if your jammer is stuck, or can bridge and give your blockers more space to block and run down that clock.
The Bear City gets their fourth blocker out first, but Trisha Smackenawa finds room on the outside of turn two and is lead jammer now. We are at the two-minute mark. Mia Missile does complete the initial pass. You see Trisha now getting ridden around by Peanut Butter Panic, and that will force the call off a scoreless jam.
Only the second one this game, I believe. And, you know, and I think that's just a sign of, third one, I've been told by Shady Hawkins, are fabulous. Queen of statistics.
That's right. And we want to thank you for watching along and getting the opportunity to see. You know, again, two teams, interestingly, they're about 600 miles apart, you know, both having to travel quite a distance to get to Atlanta. But these are the second 2018 International WFTDA playoff tournament games going on. The first, of course, were in A Coruña, Spain a couple of weeks ago.
Yes, where many European teams played, but this was the right tournament for these two teams. London arrived, I believe, on Tuesday. They went to play Gotham as a bit of a warm-up.
That's correct. Yes.
I believe Gotham took the win. It was a closed door, but it was close, and I think that's sort of given London that sort of run-up and that fire that they've come in, and they've clearly come in today with.
Oh, yes. They've been playing a very strong game. And again, This is Bear City with their final stoppage. They're having an official review used as a timeout. So, well, you know, you can't fault Bear City for effort and wanting to get the most out of the game. Now they're trying a little bit of a jammer switch as the 5 second signal goes up.
That tactic is very much to try and confuse the London jammer, Jack Attack, on this jam, but it is Mia Missile who is the jammer for Bear City. It's a tactic we've seen more frequently in the last year. Bit of fun and games on the jam line.
Yes, every possible gambit to try to gain an advantage has been thought of and used. Jack Attack on a scoring pass is lead jammer now. Mia Missile getting held up at the rearward portion of the pack by a strong London formation. Okay, there's 5 more. London points takes them to 235. Just 36 seconds to go on the period clock.
Yep, but as we said, for those of you not used to roller derby, we will go until the jam ends or the period clock, but the jam clock goes on longer if it's already underway. So just because it's at 22 seconds doesn't mean the action will stop.
That's exactly right. And now, of course, Mia Missile run to the outside. Jack Attack persevering up front. 5 more points. And we got to wonder now, however, though, if London may just call off this jam at the 0 period point. 5 more going up.
If I was London, I would be letting this run long because it's about the points differential and the rankings now. So they've got 30 seconds, probably 2-3 passes. I mean, that's 10-15 points, and that will make a difference.
Yeah. Star pass now to Master Blaster, Jack Attack, already with 20, and that will prompt the call-off. London hitting 250, Bear City 58. London making a statement. Atlanta's watching this game. They're saying, okay, we've got to play the number 5 seed in a few hours, essentially.
Yeah. 8 o'clock tonight.
8 o'clock tonight, so 8 hours from now, essentially.
Yeah.
And mark your calendars and clocks accordingly. I see walking over to turn 1 is Electra Blue, and she's going to have a post-game interview with Jukebox from London, and maybe Jukebox can tell a little bit about how she maintained her commitment to London Brawling over the last couple of years. She was definitely playing a strong game today.
Absolutely. Couldn't tell that she'd had a break from the sport, but I think also Bear City got a lot of positives to take away. I mean, this is their first time to playoffs, and they gave everything to that game. And I think that they'll take a lot away from this and think about this. And you know, obviously we'll have consolation games. They will be playing either Bay Area or Queen City later today.
That's right. And, of course, next up, I believe, Windy City and Rat City, Chicago and Seattle will be doing battle on the competition track here. It's been a very interesting game. You've got to give Bear City credit for continuing to push. But London, as we said at the beginning, they wanted to make a statement, and quite frankly, they did.
Absolutely, and thank you for everybody who's joined us on Twitch. You've had
yes.
a great game to watch. Lots of passion and enthusiasm on the track. And like we said, if this has inspired you to learn more about roller derby, go to wftda.com/new.
Yep.
And that's got all the information on how to play roller derby and how it all works.
Yeah, and you'll learn a lot more. There are leagues all over the world, so no matter where you are, you'll be able to find a group of like-minded athletes and start your roller derby career. As soon as possible, we would like to send it down to Electra Blue.
Just before we do, just a reminder, if you want to watch the rest of the weekend's action, go to wftda.tv for your pass. You can, and it's, I think it's $15?
$15, $17 that neighborhood. If you can afford a pizza, you can afford a weekend of WFTDA.TV coverage of the 2018 International WFTDA Playoffs from Atlanta, Georgia.
Hi there, this is Electra Blue, and I'm joined by Jukebox of the London Rollergirls. We just saw them take a win from Bear City, 250-58. So congratulations on the win, and we'll talk about the game in a second. Congratulations in order on two fronts. I understand you had a little girl,
yes,
and I think she just photobombed us right behind us. So last year you took some time off to be on the bench.
Yeah.
And coaching and be pregnant. So personally, as a woman and coming back to skate at this level, like, how do you come back to skate at this level and get enough sleep, first of all?
Well, we're lucky. She's a very good sleeper. But I think I have a lot of support from, like, my league, my partner. He stays home while I go to training for the most part. And so I think it takes a lot of determination. But, you know, it takes a village, you know. And actually, like, the group of teammates that helped during about to watch her call themselves the village. So thank you, guys. Thank you, LRG. Thank you, Kitty, and all of our support.
It can be done.
But a lot of determination. So.
And okay, so being a coach, how do you feel that helped you as a skater? You know, strategy wise and mentally.
I've been coaching like for a really long time, and I really enjoyed stepping into the bench role. It was a good way to like keep my brain firing while and keep up with the game, because I feel like that's really hard. Like, you know, the starts and so much changes just within the span of a year, and so getting to keep that going really helps. I find coming back, it's actually a bit frustrating because my brain is a lot faster than my body can move in terms of how it used to be. So I'm like, she's going to the out. There she goes. But you know, I have a really steep learning curve. So every jam, it gets a little bit better.
Oh, and you lost a couple key blockers this year, one to retirement, one transfer.
Yeah.
So rebuilding, but you paired up with Onyeka. Oh my goodness gracious. doing okay out there, jammer killers. Now, we saw a pretty big jammer rotation. Obviously, first game of the day, you got to come back tonight at 8:20 to play Atlanta. A little strategy involved in that, feeling out jammers?
I think it's a lot more of just like getting a win, executing well, expending as little energy as possible, knowing that like we've got a really tough game against a great opponent, Atlanta, tonight. So we're really looking forward to that game. We're very prepared, and we just want to make sure that everybody's like fit and ready to go. Yeah.
Well, that definitely makes sense. You got to play twice in one day.
Yeah.
Sometimes it's, you know, I mean, there's an advantage or disadvantage. I would say
like getting to like get a crack at the floor beforehand, it's good. I mean, this is the floor Atlanta trains on, so I'm pretty sure they're pretty familiar with it, so it's good for us to get another crack at it. Yeah,
I think so. I mean, I always, you know, those people like, oh, they get to rest, and now Atlanta gets to watch them and all that. But in, you know, you're warmed up, you're ready to go. You fielded all your jammers, you've kind of tightened up the game, and
you know what's really nice is actually on our way here, we flew out to New York and we played Gotham as a warm up game, and so thanks Gotham, it's like the best warm up game you could have asked for.
Fantastic warm-up game. Another good game here. We got more to come. We'll see these guys back here at 8:20 tonight. And y'all just keep watching at WFTDA.tv.